Gillenor, the magical world of RuneScape. It's divided into chunks for easy use. Welcome to Chunkman Dead Die Kill, the series where I conquer the landmass of Gillenor by doing tasks and unlocking chunks. Last episode we completed three tasks, being the Nature Spirit quest and the Haunted Mine quest, bringing us up to a total of 20 quests done. The last task was another total level task, bringing us up to a total of 1100. Our map expanded with the chunk with the Old Crone east of the Slayer Tower, the chunk south of the ruins of Unka, and lastly another desert chunk north of the ruins of Unka, being the quarry. This last chunk gave us the possibility to complete another quest, Inakra's Lament. We're going to start where we ended off last episode, gaining some levels to get to the required levels for that quest. And there we go, that's 52 mining. I'm going to finish the inventory and then we should have around 150 gold ore, so that should be enough for all the jewelry. So I made all my rubies into rings for rings of forging. I made all the emeralds also into rings for the dual arena teleports. Now I'm left with the sapphires, and I was thinking about what the next best crafting training method was, and I can go and kill some more cows for their leather. That's an option. But usually what an Iron Man does is, I have some seaweed from Temprose, then use some buckets of sand and then make molten glass and items. But there isn't really a nearby bank if I'm going to buy these, so usually you buy this from the charter ships and there's not really anything close by. So I'm going to make all my sapphires into bracelets. Those bracelets can then be enchanted into bracelets of clay, and then I have 28 clay I can mine, and they are automatically soft clay, and then I can fire them into pots and whatever. It's still going to be fairly slow to do this, but I think this will be the best way to go about it. And that's 45 farming. So now we can grow our maple tree. I'm going to put it over here in the farming patch at Lumbridge, and I already got the protection for the oranges. I bought 5 from the traders in Port Sarum. So let's go plant that one so that can grow. We're still 8 levels off, so the tree will be grown in that time. So I bought a brown apron so we can get into the guild, in the crafting guild, because we are now over 40 crafting. So here we have the potter's wheels and some clay. We can't use the bank chest because we need the heart or elite tier of the Falador diary, so I brought a lot of bracelets of clay with me. And this is probably going to be the home for me until I get at least a few levels, or I'll probably run out of bracelets of clay. So the plan is to mine rocks, use the potter's wheel, fire the pots, drop the pots, and repeat. And with this last diamond ring, which will be a useful ring of life, that's 50 crafting. We can now make ruby amulets, so that means we can make amulets of strength. And I don't have any rubies left because I used them all. So as soon as I get a ruby, we'll be making the ruby amulet into an amulet of strength. Now let's see our maple tree. And here we are at the maple tree. Let's check the health. Pretty good drop 3.4k experience, and let's chop at least one log for the quest, and then let's see what else we need, and then we can start. One of the items we need is a candle, so we're here at the Lumbridge Swamp, where we have the entrance to the Lumbridge Swamp Caves. If we talk to this guy, he should sell us a candle at an extraordinary amount. I'll have to take more money. Alright, this should be everything. Let's go to the quest start. Let us first of all unlock the chunk to start the quest. And let's talk to Lazim. So pretty much what he asked us is to make a statue, as he is unable to make one himself. Let's mine some sandstone and let's build it. Alright, that's 32 kilograms. Let's give him to Lazim and see what we have to do with it. Alright, time to make the statue. First of all, it's the base. Let's place it. Now, to complete the body, let's add that to the statue. Now the body has some arms. Cutting it into a nice shape. And now for a head. Alright, let's chisel the granite we just mined for a head. Let's use the head of a camel. And there we go, right into a hole because of the weight of the statue. Let's talk to Lazim. Apparently he tricked us into doing this. Alright, he says he will share the treasure with us, and we need some of the limbs of the statue we made as keys. Editor Dead here. Up until this point the quest was pretty clear to me, but after this, even reading up on the wiki about it, things weren't that clear, so I will let the clips run in the background and narrate the most important things that happened. First of all, we opened the four doors in each corner with the limbs of the statue we made. Each time a door was opened, we got a cutscene of something that happened a long time ago. We found three sigils lying around, the L, the Z, and the M, the consonants of Lazim's name. We used those to open three doors in the middle of the dungeon and then went upstairs. There was a door holding us back from proceeding, so we finished the trials in each corner of the room. And in one of the corners we used the maple log which we needed to grow our tree for. In the room after that there was a bone guardian which was easily dealt with by using the crumble undead spell. Then in the last room another bone guardian kept attacking us while we were talking to him. So using the protect from melee prayer we could talk in peace. We then built a wall between the person that put the spell on the bone guardian and the bone guardian himself to break that spell. And after the spell was broken, he turned into a camel god, and Enakra, the person who put the spell on him, appeared and they teleported away to fight once more. And that quest completed. We get 2 quest points, 7000 crafting experience, 7000 magic experience, 7000 mining experience, and 7000 fire making experience, which is pretty good. And the camulet, which allows us to talk to camels. And this gives us 57 magic and 53 mining. That's 2 nice levels. But more importantly, The quest has been finished, so that means we get another task done and another chunk. Back to the spreadsheet, our 21st quest was a Knuckles Lament. That's completed. With 82 chunks in total now. And back to the map. Let's see which chunk we get. Pick a chunk. And we get another part of the wilderness. Not really that useful. Alright, let's see what we can do after this quest. So with that crafting grind and the levels we got from the quest, we're up to 1115 total level. So that means we need 10 more levels. And while mining the soft clay, we've gotten 3 beginner clues. And with the last beginner clue casket grind, we got up to another 9 keys. So we actually only need 6 more to be able to get to 50 kill count on Obor and finish that boss. So I'm going to do that. See what comes first, if I get the giant keys first, the reward caskets, or the levels. Only a few hill giants later and we already got our ruby back. So after this trip I will be making the Amulet of Strength. I got up to 8 caskets and got pretty lucky with the giant keys. I'm up to 13, but as Obor drops keys as well, I'm going to do all 13, hope I might get 1 or 2 extra keys, and then we'll see if we can finish the task or not. Kill number 36 for some death runes, and that's number 40 down. We get a rune two-hander, okay. And that's the 45th down for a rune chain body. Already bought one, but okay. No keys yet, but we have 3 left. And that's the last of the keys, and we don't get another key. So, 2 more kills for the final task of Obor. Let's get them. Maybe we'll have the beginners first, depending on how lucky we are on the keys. And that's already 1 extra giant key. We're at 17 caskets, so not that many kills later. Let's do it immediately. Who knows, we get another key from Obor. And there's 58 magic while killing Obor. And that's the 49th Obor down. Just 1 more to go. But we don't get a key. So, 1 more key to get from the normal hill giants. And there we go, this is the last key we need to finish our last Obor task. Let's go get our gear and let's kill Obor for the 50th time. And there he goes, the 50th Obor kill. And we got some law runes. From the entire Obor grind we got 3 giant keys, which is 1 in 16, so that's pretty average. We've gotten also a lot of rune armor, which were a lot of upgrades on our gear. For the giant keys themselves, we killed about 7,000 hill giants. We've gotten a ton of limpwort roots, which will be very useful for making all the potions we need in the long run. We also got a lot of herbs, so 31 Raynars, a few Aventos, and so on. And we also got 14 long bones and 2 curved bones, together with 151 beginner clues. So that's all pretty nice, and that's the Obor grind done. We did not get Obor's club, but we don't actually need it for anything, so as long as they don't add it as a clue step anywhere, we won't be coming back to Obor. So let's complete that task and see which chunk we get. time to finish the boss task, the 8th boss task of the account. We killed Obor 50 times, here we go. Let's complete the task. That's 8 boss chunks unlocked in total, and 83 chunks in total. And back to the map, time to pick another chunk. Let's see what we get. Pick a chunk. Ooh, we get Canifis. This means we unlock another agility core, we unlock a bank, and this is, I think, the start of the Mairiki quest line. Not sure, I think this is a quest as well. Let's see on the map which quests these are. Looking at our new chunk, let's unlock it. We can do the Creature of Frankenstein, but we still need the building itself, so that's not a possibility. And then for In Search of the Mairiki, we need a few more chunks here in the swamp, and we need Morten. So, no more new quests. There's a pub here also, so the rooftop. I think the food shop has a raw shark, which is always useful, but I'm not really in need of any food. And then we have some clothing, tannery, general store, and a taxidermist. So overall, it's going to be a useful chunk, but at the moment we cannot do anything here. If we look at the bank, we have 18 beginner caskets, so we only need 7 more. And if we look at the total level, we are at 1118, so we need 7 more. And I think I'm going to do some temporos. I'll probably get 2 levels of fishing, or 3 levels of fishing, and the rest of them will be in construction from repairing the masts. And with this last mast here, that's going to be 34 construction, which in turn gives us 1125 total. So we gained 2 fishing levels and 5 construction levels. So I'll just finish the kill here and then we'll see which chunk we get. So that was our 136th kill. So this took about 34 kills to get all the levels. So we're still quite far off the 250 mark to finish this task. We are also at 424 reward points, but as I said, I'm not going to open them until I get a higher level to get the better fish, so probably when I reach 250 kill count at Temporos. Either way, let's finish the total level task on the spreadsheet and let's find out which chunk we get. Our 45th total level task, getting 1125 total, is now completed. One more and we reach the halfway mark for the total levels. Not bad. And back to the map. Let's see what we are going to get. Pick a chunk. And we get the Dark Wizard's Tower and the left part of Valador. There's some mining spot here, but that's not really that interesting. We can't get into anything from Valador either. But we are getting closer to a very interesting chunk, so the Valador Main Square, the Taverly Square, the Entrana Square. But for the moment, this chunk is not that useful. That's going to be all for this episode. Finishing Obor was a big accomplishment, and many other bosses will follow in the future. Next week we will continue to unlock more of the map. I hope to see you there.